Yep, summer is here, and we've got plenty of reasons to celebrate. This week, we're celebrating 140 of the best bass anglers in the world coming together on one of the hottest fisheries in the nation. Big ones in the mix, big names as well, today.
Yes, indeed. Welcome to the Bassmaster Elite Series, but today, it's more than that. Matter of fact, we're going to make a little history today with the first ever BASSfest. We got, well, not only the Elite Series players, we got guys coming over from the Bass Pro Shops. Bassmaster opens a field of 140, 5 days of fishing. We're going to lay it all out for you, but I think the first thing we need to lay out is this magnificent playing field we have in Mark Zona, Lake Chickamauga. The Bassmasters were back here in the early 90s. It didn't play back in those days the ways this place is playing now.
Tommy, some of the biggest five fish stringers from the locals that live here have been caught on this lake in the early spring. But since then, this lake has received a ton of pressure. Come down here with me. Look at this. Scattered all over the map. Jigs, chatterbaits, swim baits, worms, crankbaits. Throw this in. Hair jigs from the 1970s. And not only that, really the bass are all over the map. Some of our leaders catching them in 20 feet of water. Some of our guys, 6 inches of water, a lot of anglers very spread out here.
A lot of diversity, that's what we like to see. This will be a fun one as they try to figure out on the Tennessee River, Chickamauga Lake right here. And look at some of the players who are already distinguishing themselves in this thing. Kevin Van Dam, doing big on the first couple of days, former classic champ. He was back here in the 90s in the Mega Bass event.
91, graduated.
Great pictures, I hope
Thank
we
you.
See him. I hope to see your pictures from there too. Takahiro Mori, another classic champ in the mix.
And these guys are gonna fish this tournament differently. Guys are not fishing for points here. This is for a trophy and money, and when that's involved, Michael Iaconelli will shine. Just had a great tournament at Lake Dardanelle, and he's repeating that right now here.
At day number one, it was all about the 2003 Bassmaster Classic champion, Michael Iaconelli, who loaded his boat in the space of 1 hour with over 25 pounds.
I thought it was going to be a struggle, and something happened about 11 o'clock that only happens to me once or twice a year, and it's like magic. And, you know, what happened is I got the school fired up, and they got ignited, and it became so easy.
One of the biggest names in the Bassmaster Elite Series, Edwin Evers, not far behind Iaconelli with over 24 pounds.
You know, I had a great first day. You know, you just don't really know in practice. You know, my absolute best spot that I thought I had, I haven't caught a bass there yet. But there's big ones there, you know. In practice, I made two casts there, and they're both 6-pounders, and there's a bunch of them down there, but I can't get one of them to bite, so.
Oklahoma playing big in Tennessee along with Evers. How about Oklahoma's Tommy Biffle over 24?
I had a few quality bites during practice, but I didn't think I'd catch them that good. I thought I would catch a couple of 4 or 5 pounders, maybe a 6-pounder, but it turned out a little bit better than I expected.
1 year ago, Tommy Biffle threatening to win it all on the upper Mississippi, and here he is this time of year. He really performed.
Exactly right. Win it all with a Biffle bug like he did last year, and that is what he's doing here with a heavier one. And he would get the bites on day number two, but definitely the quality has gone away.
In practice, the bigger fish have been in here, but I didn't jerk on some of the ones out there on the river the other day either, and I think one or two of them was big, so just have to go and see. I didn't fish them yesterday because I didn't need to.
You know, Tommy, and I've said it for years about Tommy Biffle, he's just a scary, daunting individual, and it appears he's getting scarier through the years.
Time has no effect on him. He just seems as strong as he ever has been. Not as strong as the days go on in this tournament. Day number two, 12 pounds, and day number three, 7.5 pounds. So a disappointing days two and three for Biffle.
Exactly. On the water with Edwin Evers on day two, the exact opposite problem of Tommy Biffle. Edwin Evers, well, he's not getting a lot of bites, but when he does pull the trigger, it is a giant bass.
You know, I just think these fish here are really hard to get fired up like that because they just have so much pressure. You know, and today is another day too. You know, yesterday we had twice as much current in the afternoon. You know, they were only running like 26,000, and yesterday they were almost running 50,000. So, you know, there's quite a bit of difference in the current today too.
There's a bite.
Golly, that's a good one. Oh, stay under, baby. Stay under, fish. Oh yeah, this is what we need right here. Oh my goodness, if you don't love the sport, I don't know what else you need to love, because I've gone all day without a bite. Oh, my heart's about pounding through my chest.
Oh my.
It's a good thing if your cameraman says, oh my, because that's why he said it. Yeah. Mm-hmm. magic of current. The magic of current.
Oh, I love current.
Well, you hear it from Edwin, you hear it from all of these guys. Current and timing, the two are inseparable.
The reason why, Iaconelli talked about that flurry when that current was running on day one. What happens is those fish won't suspend anymore. When there's no current, they're 5 to 10 feet off of the bottom. But when that current gets pouring, they'll suck to the bottom, they'll start feeding, and that's when you hear the word flurry. And Iaconelli had one on day two, but nowhere near the numbers he had on the first day.
Still no current. So, you know, you'd think, you would say to yourself, all these fish are bonus before water runs, but you never know, man. I can tell you, getting a bite is a big, important thing. Just getting one to commit. A lot of times it'll fire that school up, and that's what I'm hoping happens here. So I'm trying to, you catch that fish, and then you try to get back in the exact spot as many times as you can and keep them riled up. Come on, stay fired up, you guys. Come on. Come on, crank this thing, man. There's one big one.
Big one.
Four-pounder. It's a way to start the day.
Yeah, disappointing days two and three for Michael Iaconelli. Kevin Van Dam, though, a different story. Day number one, he was in fifth place. On day number two, he moves up all the way into second place with 45 and a half pounds.
Van Dam will tell you, though, this is not an easy thing. You look at those giant bass right there, definitely quality, but you've got to know what you're doing.
They are smart. You've got to trick them, you know, especially days like today when there's not much current. The fish aren't really actively feeding, so you got to be a little sneaky to catch them when it's like this. You know, there's a couple of us fishing the spot, the same little area, Russ Lane and Jeff Crete too, and we're kind of all moving around, and we kind of figured it out as a group, you know, that these fish had changed. I mean, where we caught them today, none of us had had a bite yesterday. So it was just one of those deals where we're sharing that water. There's a good school of fish around there, and, you know, things kind of fell into place.
Everything fall into place. Van Dam positioning himself right where he wants to be. The only better spot would be the spot held by this man, Jacob Wheeler.
29 pounds, 13 ounces, with 52 pounds, Jacob Wheeler wrecks him here at BASSfest.
First 2 days of the first ever BASSfest are now in the books. And look at the big names we promised you. Van Dam, Hackney, Omori, Swindle, and more. But the man on top, 23-year-old Jacob Wheeler. And if you weren't among the top 50, well, you had to do something different on day number three. You had to go down to Lake Nickajack for the Last Chance Tournament. 10 spots still available in the field to fish the final 2 days. That's what these guys were down there on Nickajack doing. Some of them with some great, great success.
Yeah. Oh, my God. Yeah. Yeah!
Woo! BASSfest 2014 is brought to you by Evan Williams Bourbon. Yamaha. Skeeter Boats. And by Bass Pro Shops.
Good thing your cameraman says, oh my, because that's why he said it. Yeah.
29 pounds, 13 ounces. BASSfest becomes a Wheeler Whack Fest.
Well, that's a good way to put it right there. We are seeing plenty of big fish, not big numbers, but the ones they catch are good, especially the big names at the top of the leaderboard at the first ever BASSfest. Now, the way this BASSfest works, we started with the 107 anglers from the Bassmaster Elite Series, folded in 33 from the Bass Pro Shops Bassmaster Opens, a field total 140 anglers. Day number two, well, of course, that's the second qualifying day, and only 50 advance.
Right, and the bottom 90 anglers, we're going to put them on Nickajack Lake. We're going to zero their weights, and the top 10 anglers from that day, they will get back into our field of 50.
And only 12 will advance when that field of 60 now fishes in the semifinals. The 12 will go to the final round in the $120,000. Let's take a look at what happened on Lake Nickajack, starting with Keith Combs.
Well, remember the movie Escape from New York with Snake Plissken?
I do.
Well, it was Escape from Nickajack. And unfortunately, one of the guys we were on all day long, Keith Combs, he would catch them, but they were not the ones he needed.
We're on the board. It's long and skinny.
Well, Keith Combs finishing in 27th place. Again, you have to be in the top 10 if you want to get back into the field. Let's go to Dean Rojas.
And Rojas was the first angler out of the cut. Literally the first angler. He said, Dean Rojas was a little bit vocal about it. He said, Zona, I hate ledge fishing tournaments. I don't dislike them. I truly hate them. My boat will be near the bank back on Chickamauga and here on Nickajack.
There's one.
Nice one.
Yes. All right. Number three. Take. Yes.
Dean Rojas, good moment, but he will not make it back in. How about Brock Mosley came in from the Open Series, but also a veteran of the Carhartt Bassmaster College Series.
We covered him when he fished for Ole Miss, and the thing to remember here on the second chance day, you don't need to win, you just need to be in the top 10.
One thing is I don't think these fish get fished very much at all. I don't think there's any pressure here. I mean, you got Gunnersville on one side of it, and you got Chickamauga on the other. And Nickajack's, I mean, just as good. But I don't think people come here. I think they'd rather go to Gunnersville or Chickamauga.
Brock Mosley, obviously a good attitude, seeing the potential that's there at Nickajack, and he goes to work, and it's obviously a different-looking situation here.
Really, it's been a 1-2 punch, throwing a little shallow-running crankbait and a topwater popper. And Tommy Sanders, I'm going to tell you something right now. I'm going to look at a couple key catches throughout his morning. One of the best topwater fish catches coming right here that we have ever captured.
Again, this is Brock Mosley. This is the second chance day, trying to fish his way in. Wow, you're right. That is fantastic.
Exactly. A lot of the anglers that we thought would do well today, Combs, Dean Rojas, well, one of the anglers we covered back in the college days, excelling.
I mean, with what I got right now, I think if I catch 1 5-pounder, I may have enough. That'll give me close to 16 pounds. Yeah, one more big one. I mean, it could happen. Any flip, I could catch a 5. I feel that. I feel that way.
Be a big one. Yeah. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, oh, come here. Come here. Come here. No. Yeah! Yeah! Give me some, man. Boo!
Yeah, Brock Mosley knew what he had to do to get it done on Nickajack. Great attitude, great execution. Take a look at the results for him. 15 pounds and 7 ounces. That's good enough for 7th place. He's going back for the last 2 days of fishing back on Chickamauga. But everyone following this guy, the number one man on Nickajack, Skyler Hamilton.
25 pounds and 13 ounces.
How about getting the job done on Nickajack? Look at that bass right there, Skyler Hamilton, impressing everyone.
Giant bass from Skyler Hamilton. He would tell our Bassmaster reporters, that day right there, the best day of bass fishing in his entire life.
Leads the way back into the semifinals, this field of 10. Some names you're familiar with, some young names coming up there. How about Mike McClellan, the veteran, the last man to sneak back into the field. So for these guys now, 2 days of fishing to decide the winner of BASSfest. Let's turn it over to Dave Mercer in 6 seconds.
We know our pros know all about fishing, but what do they know about other sports? If we were to play a sport and you were to get a nutty, what sport would that be?
A nutty?
Get a what? A nutty.
A nutty?
If I got what?
A nutty.
A nutty?
Oh my goodness, that sounds really dirty. I don't know.
I don't have a clue.
I don't know.
Horseshoeing?
Rugby.
That's not a good guess, dude. That was a terrible guess.
What is a nutty again?
That's the question. I don't know, soccer. Nailed it. It is soccer. It's when you kick the ball between somebody's legs. In what sport do you use a brassy?
A brassy?
A brassy?
I don't have a clue on that one either.
Golf.
A brassy.
It's another term for your two wood.
You pull off an egg beater. What are we doing?
I have no idea.
An egg beater.
I have nothing for egg beater.
Water polo.
I don't know, dude. Water polo? Really?
Me and you, we should go fartlek together. What would we be doing? Nothing we should be.
I don't even want to comment on that one, Dave. Fartlek? Really?
What did you say again?
I said let's fartlek together.
Okay, I don't know.
I don't know. That sounds something like you and Zona doing your own time.
How long do we need to know each other before we can fartlek together?
You know, we need to go on a couple dates at least.
6 seconds left, yeah.
Definitely. It's running.
Yeah, but I've never heard that term either.
You've never heard of fartlek training?
Heard of that ever.
Google it.
As soon as we leave here, I'm going to Google it.
It's our coverage of the first ever BASSfest Lake Chickamauga. A lot of the guys in the field have never competed here before, but Bass was here back in the 80s and 90s. In fact, they had a classic here. There's a few guys in the field who remember those days.
The most magical thing about that week, that was my first BASS win. You know, for me to be able to come back to this lake this many years later and see how much his fisheries changed for the good, it has a lot to say for the Tennessee fisheries here.
The new champion of the Bassmasters Classic, Charlie Reed. Let's bring him up.
We had the Classic here, and I think Charlie Reed won it with very little.
Well, I tell you, back then, that was a three-day event at the Bassmasters Classic, and I finished fourth with 22 pounds, 1 ounce. So, you know, 22.5 won it, and that was a three-day competition.
It was pretty easy to catch a limit. Back then, it was a seven-fish limit, you know, and 12 pounds was pretty good. You caught a lot of fish. You know, you didn't catch the weight that they're catching now.
1992, we had a Bassmaster Megabucks here in the fall. The lake had a little bit of grass in it then, but it didn't have any Floridas in it. And I mean, you would go and literally catch seven bass that weighed 5 pounds. It's just night and day different. It's definitely a whole different lake in a good way. These are the good old days for Chickamauga.
Well, it's a pretty big week for Chickamauga here, BASSfest week. We've got 5 days of fishing when you count in the day on Lake Nickajack. And as we begin the first semifinal round, hey, Jacob Wheeler, the guy on top, look at the guys chasing him. He's got Kevin Van Dam, although almost 7 pounds back. There you see Hackney, Matt Heron, Takahiro Amori. Kevin Van Dam's the first guy we're going to look at today, heading to his spot, which is not unknown.
No, it's not. It is one of the biggest community holes on the lake. Van Dam running a little bit over 20 miles, Tommy Sanders, and when he would show up to his area down near, everybody calls it down near the power plant, well, he has been sharing this area with Russ Lane and Jeff Creed in a dynamic that we just do not see at all ever on the Bassmaster Elite Series. These three anglers are sitting on three different schools of bass, and they've worked throughout this entire tournament trying to fire up each school. They've kind of moved around each day, and when one bass bites, that's when the other anglers will come in. So really, they'll divide in the morning, try to get the school to fire, get one bite, and then come in on top of them.
Russ got one. Good one too. I think they move, this school's moved. What happens a lot of times is they're wadded up in such a tight spot that you'll pull the whole school off there. You know, if you get in the vicinity, they're still eating, but they don't last long. There's one. Big one too. There's a nice one. He ate it too. That'll work. Getting a start on it. Finally get a decent bite. 4 pounder. Let's see if he's got some friends out there. That's fun when you get on them like that, you know? That's what they do though every day. There's another one. Big one too.
And that's been the main thing throughout this week. Get these schools ignited in some way, shape, or form. We were stunned these guys were not catching these bass on crankbaits, whether it's hair jigs or structure jigs. The main thing on this lake, these fish have been throttled with crankbaits the last few months. Very, very subtle techniques have worked.
And that flurry right there from Van Dam pretty much erased the deficit, which he started the day behind this guy, Jacob Wheeler. Pretty amazing angler, 23 years old from Indiana. Has been the man on top the past couple of days in this BASSfest event. And Jacob Wheeler shocked us all on day number two with his giant bag of fish.
29 pounds, 13 ounces with 52 pounds. Jacob Wheeler wrecks him here at BASSfest.
I think it's an awesome format. I mean, you think about it in a regular game, whether it's football, basketball, or anything else, you have halftime. You know, so in between, two quarters are done. 2 days are done, we have a halftime, 1 day off, and allows us to say hey to the fans, talk to people, and get our stuff done, rest a little bit, and get back out and fish the next day. And so that's really something pretty cool and something totally different than anything else out there. That first bite, that first fish in the morning is gonna be nice. Little guy. I ain't caught a little one off yet. Let's see. Get a little measuring board out. Number one. Not a big one, but you don't know how much a fish, just one fish, starts the morning off. Calms you down a little bit. We're getting a rhythm. Now we need a bigger one for sure.
Well, 2 days ago when he caught the 29-pound plus bag of fish, things started a lot earlier for Jacob Wheeler. He's having to kind of wait on him on this morning, having to be a little bit patient as we get over to the guy who won the first event of the year on the regular season, Brett Height.
Throwing the exact same thing, throwing a chatterbait. And here's what's gone on in this event so far. It was thought to be dominated out on the ledges. Any Tennessee River Lake right now, whether it's Gunnersville, Kentucky Lake, Pickwick, it is a ledge fishing deal. That really was not the case here. You look at Brett Height catching fish up shallow. Matt Heron definitely utilized the shallow water throughout this entire event. And a lot of these anglers thought there was a potential to win this 7 foot of water and less.
You know, first 2 days here on Chickamauga have been really interesting. Tennessee River fish really like to feed when we got current. So we've only been getting some quality current, you know, up over 30,000. For 2 to 3 hours in the afternoon. So the mornings has been the big deal, is just trying to make a few stops, get a few bites in the boat, and wait for that 1 to 2 hour window to be in some areas where you've got some schools of fish. Here we go. He ain't figured out he's caught yet. Come here. Come here. Come here, sweetie. Come here. Come to daddy. It'll be all over with in just a moment. Come here. 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 I got too much dang of line out. Belly hook a 3.5 pounder this morning.
Well, I'll take a belly rabbit.
Well, now Matt Heron doing something a little bit different from our two guys in the lead there. Matt Heron, a man to watch as we continue here. He was in sixth place after the first day, moved it up to fourth place. So the trend is going the right direction for Matt Heron. Can he wade out that current he was talking about a little bit earlier? And Greg Hackney wade his way back into this field. It's all coming up next, our leader as well, when we return.
Boom! Yeah! Big! Son of a gun.
BASSfest 2014 is brought to you by Humminbird. Mercury. And by Minn Kota.
in Tennessee, Dayton, Tennessee, to be specific, for the first ever Bass Fest, kind of a summertime gathering of everyone who loves professional bass fishing. We got programs for high schoolers. There's a college tournament going on here. Just a lot of great stuff happening for everyone. Lots to see in the fish department as well.
And we can see this Tommy Sanders, the Evan Williams Bourbon Shot of the Day of the Week. Hank Cherry with a Mega Chickamauga Slouch.
That is pretty impressive right there. We have been seeing that all week long. Not everyone has shared the bounty, but boy, we've seen some impressive stringers of fish as we get out to Matt Heron impressing us on this semifinal day.
Exactly right. Matt Heron fishing very shallow. He's got a little outside deal, a little ledge deal later in the day, but a lot of his fish coming very, very shallow early in the morning. Matt Heron starting to mount a charge.
Well, you know, what's going on is these fish are post-spawn and they haven't really committed to go to the river. There ain't a lot of current there. And they're kind of hung up between the deep deal and the shallow deal. And they're sitting up on the corners of these spawning bays. And in the middle of the day, you know, in the depth range that they're in, they need shade. And that's the big deal. It's all about a little structure, a little shade, a little comfort. And they're laying up under there, and all of a sudden, the cheap, easy meals comes through, and they're like, hey, you know, I'm under here resting anyway. I might as well have a snack. That is a big one. I mean, a big one.
Hey, Rick.
Come here. Come here. Come here. Come here. That'll make a fat boy giggle. I caught one off air yesterday. Yeah. Hey man, I'm telling you, catching these suckers ain't easy. Ready? Big one. Open your mouth and come here to me, boy.
What was that? I'm sorry.
Telling you what, Matt Heron a little fired up right there, and he should be. Look at him. He is virtually tied our leader, Jacob Wheeler, with that flurry right there. So Matt Heron on the right track. Let's take a look at Jason Williamson. He had a great start to this week. Knocked out 21 pounds, 3 ounces on day number one. Followed it up with 17-10, and today he's just trying to hang in there, keep his place, so he can be among the 12 who fishes on the final day.
And again, a lot of guys that are out fishing the ledges, whether it's Van Dam, Wheeler, guys like Williamson, they're not getting a ton of bites, but the quality is there. So many anglers coming into this tournament throughout this area, they were wanting to see that historic 5 bass for 45 pounds, but that just doesn't go on here this time of year. That's a February, March deal, but what has happened since then, getting out to Greg Hackney, a lot of these anglers that are up fishing shallow feel, because of that phenomenon that happens here in February and March, that these deeper fish get pounded with umbrella rigs. And a lot of these guys fishing shallow thought they were totally left alone coming into this event where those deeper fish were hammered on.
All right, yeah, everyone's saying those ledge fish are educated bass out there. You got to be pretty good to catch them. Getting them fired up is not an easy proposition as we go shallow to watch Hackney.
So burn this jig around a little bit. It's a little bit, you know, it's a little subtler, no vibration. I can reel it faster than that bladed jig, so just to see.
Big one.
Well, ain't that big, but he's a keeper. Man, don't come off, buddy. I can't tell how he's hooked. Number 5. Finally. God, I thought it was a giant. Well, you got that thing was running. That's a 3-pounder, you know. Number 5. Woo! Woo! Dang, I thought it was a big one. That sucker smoked out. I was like, God. And the only other bite I've had here has been a big one, so
And there you have it, Greg Hackney over the first 2 days of this event, carving out a place near the top. He can continue to menace the rest of the bass fishing world as he has over the past month or two. Maybe the hottest guy in fishing and almost within a point of having caught Mark Davis in Toyota Bassmaster Angler of the Year points.
Exactly right. Not only that, just won an FLW tournament. And really, let's take a look at the lakes that we have left on the Bassmaster Elite Series. And to me, the next tournament is the X factor of the whole season, the Delaware River in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. The reason why, there's just not a lot of history there. Michael Iaconelli, he knows it well, but I guarantee you, as we sit here right now, there's about 70% of our anglers practicing there as we speak.
That's, of course, Iaconelli land, but you say anybody could prosper there.
Absolutely. From there, we're going to Cayuga Lake in New York, one of the Finger Lakes. And here's the deal here. That sets up for Hackney. It's a grass factory largemouth. Usually we have big smallmouth tournaments there. Not the case that one in Hackney's wheelhouse. From there, we are going up to Lake Michigan, up in Escanaba, Michigan, Bay du Nord. And here, if Aaron Martins makes it, if he's just consistent the next two tournaments, gets to here, it could be right in his wheelhouse. And here's what I'm not doing. I am not dissing our Angler of the Year leader right now, Mark Davis. But you look at guys that are gaining traction and momentum, and you're starting to see a little bit of a slip from Mark Davis. I look for the two behind him to be very powerful.
Back out on this semifinal day. Again, you have to be in the top 12 if you want to fish the finals. Kevin Van Dam in that carousel with Russ Lane right there and Jeff Creep chasing a finite number of fish.
Exactly right, and they kind of protected this little area here. This was not a mile-long stretch. There was, you know, three 20-yard stretches, and when other anglers would want to come in, you see Mike Iaconelli right here, well, sometimes anglers butted heads.
You think that's cool? I said, you think that's cool?
Just tell me to leave, Kevin, and I'll leave. You'll have to get mad at me.
I'm just asking you, I just wonder if that's cool.
It's a beauty hole.
You ain't part of the community.
Kevin, next time just say Mike. Can you please leave the spot? Just be nice about it. I'll leave.
I wasn't mean. Whatever you want, dude.
Be nice next time. I'll leave for it. That's all.
I was nice. How was I mean? I just said, is that cool? He's having a bad day, I can tell. Mike and I don't have the best relationship, if you hadn't figured it out.
I can tell.
Well, okay, there you go, right there, enough said. We go back out to Jacob Wheeler, our leader, not fishing that particular part of that said community hole.
But if you notice, the ledge fisherman struggling in a big way today. Jacob Wheeler still without a limit.
Biggin', dude. Giant. Don't jump. Oh, it's giant. Don't do it. Come here, baby, get your butt in here. Go. Come here. Oh, gosh. You ready? Come up here, babe. Take your time. I'm gonna bring her around. You wore out yet? Okay, come here. All right, come here. Boom! Yeah! Biggin'! Son of a gun. Biggins right there. Woo! Yes! It's the kind we need.
Woo! Jacob Wheeler, his day has been going slow up to this point. As a matter of fact, he had lost his lead to the likes of Kevin Van Dam and Matt Heron, but that fish right there. Jacob Wheeler is right back on top. Can he hang on to that, or is there an answer coming from the likes of Heron and Van Dam? We'll find out.
Trust me, it has been a memorable day.
Think about me now.
Back at the Bassmaster, first ever BASSfest on Lake Chickamauga, Dayton, Tennessee. If you're having your own kind of BASSfest, catching them like that, do not hesitate to send us your photo. Tweet your catch, hashtag big catch. We want to see it right now. Big catch has been the word this week on Lake Chickamauga. What an amazing fishery. Not a lot of big catches, but boy, when you get a good one, they are big here. Let's get out to Takahiro Amori. Started out like a house of fire, 22 pounds, 15 ounces. Been slipping a little bit on day two. Today's slow.
And the one dynamic we've seen in this tournament, in BASSfest, where there's no points on the line. A lot of these anglers that are usually bank feeders, guys like Biffle, Takahiro Amori, all of them fishing offshore trying to win the event.
Takahiro Amori, again, struggling on this third day of fishing on Lake Chickamauga. As we watch some footage of him from this day, watch this. He's definitely not feeling very well, fishing from his back right there. Severe health issue for Tak on this day on the water.
Tak, under the weather, saw some pictures of you on the blog, actually laying on your back in the boat, still fishing. So basically, you don't even need to stand up to beat these guys, right?
That's so true. I'm just sick, you know.
Well, I will give you, you get the day off tomorrow, give you a little bit of a rest, and we will see you back here on Saturday, Takahiro fishing for sure.
Yeah, I have something wrong my heart. I had to go to the local clinic here in Dayton, then I had to go to Chattanooga emergency room yesterday, and I had an unusual heartbeat, so I might have a heart attack. But my dad died of heart attack, so I guess I had it in my family. And I had nitrogen medicine, but if I have something feel wrong, I'm done for fishing. Call 911, I go back to the emergency room.
That is absolutely frightening as we watch Takahiro and the shape he's in on this third day. It's amazing that he's still out there doing it. The whole fishing community pulling for him on this day, and of course he would be really prevented from fishing the way he wanted to fish and finishes in 19th place, so he will actually take a break after this day.
Exactly, right around the corner, going to get back out with Van Dam. And one of the things that we've seen today, you see Wheeler struggling, Van Dam struggling. They've been so dominant out on the ledges. That is from the lack of current. We saw some fish earlier from Van Dam, but if you notice, most of the fish that have been caught today by Wheeler and Van Dam, they've come on that hair jig, fish that are suspended off the bottom targeting gizzard shad. Well, Van Dam once again today, visited by, well, company.
Mm-hmm. Brutal. Making a sternum today, boy. Not a nibble, sniff, snort. I'm trying to stay the course on it. And just, dude, it's brutal. Got him. If it's a bass, it's a big one. Big smallmouth. The old brown dog came to the party. We'll put him in the other side. That's a good one, 4-pounder. Finally got a bite.
Timely bite for Kevin Van Dam, and with that nice fish right there, he pulls within 4 pounds of our leader, Jacob Wheeler, and Matt Heron. Hey, he's right in there as well. He's just going to see what he can do.
You know, it's Saturday on the Tennessee River, and I was really worried about the flow. And this just kind of progressed into a new deal today. I kind of took what I did this morning and ran with it and have turned it into a pretty decent day. I mean, but you got the ideal day for what we're wanting, you know, what we're doing. But you're looking at I think a very small window of opportunity, no different than the offshore fish. I think it's a 10 to 2 bite.
Oh God. Oh God, oh God. Come here, come here, come here. Oh, come here. Knows my, in the heavens what you do. Ha ha!
think he was mad. You think I stuck him?
Solid fish there for Matt Heron, and something we did not see coming in this event at all. Taking a look here at Greg Hackney in his last few moments. This tournament was supposed to be destroyed from the deep water anglers. Jacob Wheeler, Kevin Van Dam, somehow the shallow water guys have made a statement.
There he is, it's a big one too. I ain't a big one, but I need him. Get in here.
Whew. That sucker bit hard. I thought it was gonna be a big one. He sure enough culls one though. Sure enough culls one.
Wait.
Greg Hackney trying to pick up the pace a little bit on this crucial day. Let's get back out to Jacob Wheeler, who's been run down by Matt Heron.
Well, he has, and some other people on the lake right now too. Oh, well. And one of the things that's gone on this fourth day of competition, Jacob Wheeler has really had to manage the crowds that's been around him to get on top of his own fish.
There's six of them, five or six of them down there. We get them to bite. They're not grouped up right, but it's sad because you have to play the spectator boats, you know. As soon as I leave this spot, there's going to be three or four people idling it. There's going to be probably two or three people fishing it. And so you can't leave and wait for them to set back upright. And that's tough. I mean, I'm going to tell you what, I can't see how Kevin can win so many events. He prepares for it, but he just has so many people following. For him to be able to win events with the spectator boats and understand that he needs to hold stuff back, I mean, that's unbelievable to me. Dude, it's brutal. These suckers just ain't biting.
Big one. I think it's another big one. Yeah, I think it is. Don't do it, come on. Come here, dude. Come here. Go down. Yes. Good one. Yes.
The kind we need right there.
Whew.
4-pounder.
Woo!
End of the day has been better for Jacob Wheeler. Back on top, but not by much. We're going to make it official when we come back.
BASSfest 2014. Is brought to you by Triton Boats. Nitro. Toyota. And by Berkeley.
How about this? Back at the weigh-in, the Carhartt Big Bass of the Week. Hank Cherry, and he's a big guy, so this is a little deceptive. That is a huge largemouth bass, 10 pounds and 11 ounces on day number three.
How about an angler with a lot of momentum right now on the Bassmaster Elite Series, qualifying for our final round here at BASSfest. Gerald Swindle from Alabama, sitting with 55 pounds and 11 ounces.
He's going to the finals. He'll be among the 12 who fish on the final day. So will this guy, Terry Scroggins, 2 days here. He's been just under 20 pounds. He had one slack day in there, but his effort good enough to advance him in fifth place into the top 12.
Well, it's the big show. Exactly right from there. It's our guy right here, Greg Hackney, one of the most powerful anglers on the planet right now, and he will shallow fish his way into the finals, sitting with 58 pounds and 7 ounces.
Everybody's had their eyes on Van Dam throughout this tournament. So strong on the Tennessee River. 2 days, 22 pounds plus for the first 2 days, fell off a little bit, down to 15.13 today. But still right up in there in third place, but a good ways back of the leader.
Alabama angler Matt Heron, shallow water expert, knows the Alabama River so well. Well, he also knows the Tennessee River. He will go into our finals in second place, 67 pounds and 4 ounces.
Jacob Wheeler has been the man of this tournament, 22 and a half pounds on day number one. Day number two, almost 30 pounds of bass from Lake Chickamauga. And today, well, just hanging in there with 16.2. It's good enough for the lead, but only by a pound over Matt Heron. But believe me, he's happy to be here.
Obviously, I mean, I have so much respect for the guys I'm fishing against. I mean, unbelievable respect. But without a doubt, I'm a competitor and I want to win just as bad as they do. And you know, to go out there, it's simply about getting number one, winning, catching a big bag, and taking first place, and coming out here with the hardware. As simple as that. And you know, I mean, those guys are some of the best in the world, and you have to go out there and catch them.
The best way to put it, Jacob Wheeler survived this semifinal day. Looking at the weights right now, fantastic weights. But this tournament is far from over. Really, this tournament has turned into your shallow water guys against your deep water masters.
So at this point still, it's all about Jacob Wheeler, 23 years old, and with a resume that's starting to look really, really impressive, could get real impressive at the end of it all. But he's got guys like Kevin Van Dam behind him, and especially Matt Herron has cut that deficit to a pound. Can he hold them on?
Well, really not easy to sleep with guys like Herron and Van Dam behind you. But the one thing about Jacob Wheeler, he has been there and done it, and he doesn't appear to have any chinks in the armor. And the other thing is, really going into the final day, it's going to open this lake up more. So many of these guys have been fishing on top of each other. The main thing on this final day, obviously our leaders are catching them. You better not slip up.
All right, we'll have it all for you when we revisit Bass Fest for the final day. That's next time right here on the Bassmaster Elite Series.